In this video, I'm answering 7 questions on executive attention. How can we test executive attention? What is executive attention? What's an example of executive attention? When do we need it? Where is it located in the brain? At what age do we develop it? And what's a disorder related to poor executive attention? Let's get to it. How can we test executive attention? John Ridley Stroop devised an ingenious test to study automatic reading in 1935. In this test, the color terms, for example, red, yellow, blue, and green, are printed in incompatible colors. For example, the first word yellow appears in green color, and so on. The task is to say aloud the color of the ink while ignoring the meaning of the word itself. So when you see the word yellow written in green color, you must say green and not yellow. While doing this, the word recognition, which is one aspect of fluent reading, occurs automatically because it's exceedingly difficult to ignore the meaning of the word yellow when it appears in green color. The correct response, green, competes with the habitual response of the word yellow. Errors and delays in responding of the word yellow when it appears in green are the usual result. This is how we can test executive attention, and the test is called the Stroop task. Before I tell you what executive attention is, I want to tell you this. Word recognition, which comes automatically when you do the Stroop task, illustrates one of many processes which have become automatic because of extensive practice, maturation, and skill development. Swimming, running, riding a bicycle, and typing on a keyboard are among the many motor skills which people automatize. Many mental skills also become automatic and are carried out effortlessly. Automatic process occurs unintentionally, unconsciously, and operates without depleting attentional capacity. Put differently, automatic processes are often called pre-attentive. On the other hand, controlled processes are intentional, conscious, and demanding of attention. Executive attention is an example of a controlled process. So, what is executive attention? Executive attention refers to our ability to control our responses, particularly in conflict situations where several responses are possible. So, executive attention refers to a supervisory attentional system which inhibits inappropriate responses and activates appropriate ones. Its function is to control our thoughts and behavior in adaptive ways. So instead of following our habits, we adapt to a new situation and decide to act according to that change. What's an example of executive attention? Imagine you leave a parking lot to drive home after work in the afternoon. You realize you've run out of milk though, so you decide to drive to the grocery store to get milk before you head home. In this situation, you use your executive attention because if your usual routine is to drive straight home, then executive attention is needed to intervene and activate the thought of going to the grocery store first. You must inhibit your automatic response of driving home, or else it will control your behavior. When do we need executive attention?
We need executive attention when we plan or make decisions, when we correct errors, when the response we are required to give is new or not well learned, and when conditions are dangerous. This group task, which I described at the beginning of this video, is an excellent example where active executive attention is required to give correct responses.
What's the location of executive attention in the brain? Brain imaging studies conducted during the Stroop task test have established that the anterior part of the cingulate gyrus, a region in the frontal lobe of the brain, is the location of the executive attentional system. It inhibits the automatic response and selects the correct response. At what age do we develop executive attention? Executive attention is thought to develop until early adulthood, but seems to undergo a particularly rapid development between 2 and 7 years of age. What's a disorder related to poor executive attention?
Problems with executive attention, as well as other executive functions, may underlie some of the difficulties observed in children with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. So children and adults with ADHD may experience problems caused by poor executive attention. This information came from these websites. You'll find these links below this video. If you found this video interesting, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment section below. Subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. Next Friday, I'll be interviewing Nancy Buckley, a single mother of 3 young adult children. She'll tell us about the challenges she faced while raising black children in modern-day America. Be sure to watch that interview. Till then, I only want to say 3 things. Thank you for watching. Have a great day, and bye for now.